Alright, folks, thanks for coming. We're gonna continue where we stopped. We're still dealing with linear equations in two variables, okay? This time we're gonna deal with a system of linear equations. So far we've been dealing with one equation at a time. Recall what we did. Refresh your memory what we did. We dealt with equation like this, a linear equation like this. We say it's AX plus BY equals to C, right? And then we say AB cannot all be zero, okay? Cannot all be zero, all right? And then, I can give you example like anything like 3x minus 4y is equals to 20 is example, see? This is example. This is a linear equation in two variables, okay? And then after that, we dealt with, this is called the standard form. Remember? The standard form, okay? We deal with that. And notice it's only one equation. You know, we're always dealing with one equation so far. Okay? And then notice that we also dealt with this type of equation, y equals to mx plus b. It's called a slope intercept form, okay? You remember, we just did that yesterday. This is called sloped intercept form. Alright? Where this is slope, this is y-intercept. Okay, remember that? We did that yesterday. And then we dealt with a third type of equation with today. We'll call it, it's like this, y minus y1 is equals to slope times x minus x1. Okay, remember this. This is called point slope form, okay? Point slope form, because you have a point and a slope. Point slope form. Okay, see, we dealt with these three types of equations so far. Each time we did we were considering one equation. Remember, we also have something like x equals to a or y equals to b. Remember, x equals to a is a vertical line where the slope is not defined, and this one is a horizontal line, okay? Horizontal line. This one is a horizontal line, okay, with slope is equals to zero. Remember that. So we dealt with this kind of question. Each time we were talking about one equation at a time, but this time we're gonna deal with system of linear equation. A system of linear equation, all that means is you have it can be two equations, it can be three, it can be four, it can be five, it can be 200. You know, but we haven't graduated to that yet. You know, we're only dealing with a linear equation in two variables. So we're gonna deal with a system of equation that consists of two equations, okay? But this is how they define a system of equation. A system of linear equation, a system, okay, this is a formal definition, a system of linear equations, right? It's defined as that system is two or more, Okay, two or more linear equations, okay? Two or more linear equations with the same variables, with the same variables. I'll explain that to you. With the same variables, okay? What that means is, okay, I'll read it again. A system of linear equation consists of two or more linear equations with the same variables. You get that, right? That's what that is saying, man. That means, what they mean by the same variables is, you remember we talked about you have two equations like this. I'll give you an example. Let's say you have 2x plus 4y is equals to 10, okay? And then you have another 6x plus 7y is equals to 17. So those two equations, they are a system. They consist of a system of linear equations, right? But it says it can have two or more linear equations with the same variables. That means, at least this one has two. It doesn't have you could have three, but we're gonna deal with two. But what they mean by the same variables, it has to be y over here, x over here, x over here. You can't say 2x plus 4y equals to 10, and then you come in here and say 6k plus 7t equals to 17. No, they have to have the same variables, because the next definition will help you to understand why. So, you see, it has to do with the solution. When you solve the system, right, you will get an ordered pair. You will get an ordered pair that makes all the two equations true when you put the ordered pair, right? So basically, when you're solving it, you're solving for x and y, right? You're solving for x and y. So there are different scenarios, you see. There are different things that can happen. You know, let me see the solution, right? Solution of a system, okay? A system of linear equation, right? Is just an ordered pair. We dealt with that many times. An ordered pair of numbers, right? That makes the two equations, right? The two, because we're gonna deal with two linear equations. It makes the two equations. Make the two equations of the system, right? The two equations of the system. True. Right? True. When you substitute them. Both of them have to make the ordered pair contains the value for x and the value for y. You substitute them in each equation. It has to make each of them true. Right? If it doesn't make each of them true, then let's say it makes one true and the other one not true, then that's not possible. If that happens, then that particular pair or that pair is not a solution. Okay, remember, that was something I told you before when we started this class. When we started discussing linear equation, that a linear equation can have three possible solutions, right? It applies to system of linear equations too. A system of linear equation can only have three possible solution. One, it may not have a solution. Two, it may have only exactly one solution. Or three, it may have an infinite number of solutions. You know, so Different books, you know, treat different things, you know, this topic differently, but I just want to combine them, you know. So what happened is, if you're given two equation, let's say you are given okay, two linear equations, okay, there are things that can happen. The two equations can be perpendicular. Sorry. The two equations can be perpendicular. Perpendicular to each other. They can be perpendicular, right? In other words, they cross each other like this, like that. So you know, that situation can happen. So if they're perpendicular to each other, what normally is the slope. The two equations will, each equation will have a slope. And if you multiply both slopes, slope 1 and slope 2, they will give you equals to negative 1. So each equation has a slope. You multiply those two equations, you always get negative 1 if they're perpendicular. But they will still have a solution. Even though they're perpendicular, they have what is called one solution, because they cross. They have one solution, okay? One solution. They have one solution. So I wanted to treat these at the same time, because some books, they will talk about equations that are perpendicular, equations that are parallel, equations that are neither. They treat them separately, but it's better to treat them with the system of linear equation, in my opinion, you know. So any person can do whatever they want. And then, given two equations, you can also have this situation. The two equations can be parallel. They can be parallel to each other. In other words, the two equations can go like this. This one go like that. That one go like that. They're parallel. Yeah, they don't touch. Or they can go like this, like that, or like that. They don't touch. So when this happens, what normally happens, they will have the same slope. When it happens, they will have the same slope, okay? They will have the same slope. In other words, their slope 1 will be equal to slope 2, okay? But then what happens is, they will have different, I will show you with example. They will have different y-intercept. The same slope, but different y-intercept, okay? Remember, we talked about this. You know, so, and then, but what of the solution? If you solve the system, right? If you solve them, what will happen? They won't have any solution, because they don't have any point in common. They won't have no, they will have no solution, okay? They will have no solution because they're not crossing. Because they have no point in common. Okay, they have no point in common. Because when you have point in common, you must cross. And then when you cross, you have like a point, an ordered pair like this, X, Y, you know. That you know, that shows where they cross, but this time they're not crossing. They're parallel, so they never cross, so they will never have any solution. They won't have any solution. You can't find solution for them, but their slope will be equal. Their y-intercept will be different. Okay, just keep that in mind. And then there is a situation 3. A situation 3 is where, you know, where the two equations coincide. Yeah, what I mean by that is that they coincide. Okay, so when you draw their graph, if the first equation have a graph like this, right, the second equation will have graph on top of it. They will collapse. They coincide with each other. The two equations, they just have the same graph. If one has a graph that goes like this, the other one will have a graph exactly like that, but on top of it, they will be the same graph, they will coincide. You see what I'm saying? You know, so in a situation like this, that's where we say they have infinitely many solutions. They have infinitely many solutions. See, that might be intuitive if you think about it. You know, that should be intuitive, because if they coincide, remember, a solution to a linear equation means that particular solution is on the line. Any solution you find is on the line, right? So when the two equations coincide, they will have infinitely many solutions, because each solution will be on the line, you remember? You know, so that's what that is saying. There will be an infinite number of ordered pairs that forms a solution for them, okay? So you may keep having ordered pair x 30, y 30, you see? So something like that, keep going forever, you know? So those are the only three things you're gonna have. And when they coincide, like I said, when they cross each other, they have one particular solution. They don't have to be perpendicular. They may cross like this. I was just showing you what it means to be perpendicular. But when they have one solution, they can cross like that. They can cross like that. You know, they can cross like this. You know, you see what I'm saying? You know, they can cross anywhere. But the perpendicular means, if they're perpendicular, means they are, if you multiply the product of their slope is equals to minus one. That's all that means, man. You know, so that's what we're gonna do in this section. I'm gonna give you an example, but before I give you an example, please subscribe to my channel, like and share this video, leave comments and questions under this video, okay? You know, I think that's all I want, the traversal I want to give you. Then we're going to solve a bunch of problems, okay? So let's solve a bunch of problems. I forgot to mention this. Let me mention this before we go to example. When you're solving a system of linear equation, right, there are two methods you can use. You can use what they call substitution method, or you can use what is called the elimination method, okay? I will demonstrate that to you, okay? There are many other methods. Another method that you need to remember is called matrix. You can use matrix. You remember the word matrix from a movie, where you take, let's say, a matrix is like this. Let's say you have this system of linear equation plus 4y is equals to, let's say, 10. You got 3x plus 6y equals to 20. Okay, you can put this in matrix form. You know, matrix form is like this. We'll get to that when we do linear equation. You put it like that, 4, 3, 6. Actually, no, I made a mistake. You can also put the variable. You put the variable in there, okay? Well, actually, no, this is correct. You go like this, then you say equals to 10 and 20. So this is how you abbreviate this system, you know. But we're not gonna cover that. This is a little bit advanced, so we're not gonna cover that right here. We'll leave it alone. We're just gonna cover substitution method. We're gonna cover substitution method, right? And then we'll cover elimination method. Matrix is a little bit more advanced. We'll leave it for other time. There are some other ways of solving it, but these three are very, very popular, very common. You see them in a lot of places. Listen, a system of linear equation can have 50 variables. It can have 50 equations and 50 variables. It can have 100 variables, 100 equations, but human beings cannot solve that. What they do, they arrange it, a computer will solve it. They feed it into a computer will solve it. Because the human mind is not capable of solving it. You know, I mean, you can try, but you go crazy. You see, so they do have a, see, if you have a tool, you use the tool. You know, you can see they are trying to solve a linear equation that has 100 equations and 100 variables. Good luck. You know, so, but you, since you have a computer that can solve it, then you use computer. They say, we're not going to worry about this. We'll worry about substitution method and elimination method, okay? So let me leave it there. All right, here is an example one here. What we want to do is, we want to determine if the line is, if it's perpendicular, if it's parallel, or if it's neither perpendicular nor parallel. Of course, if it's perpendicular, there's one solution, right? If it's parallel, there is no solution. If it coincide, then it has a bunch of, if they coincide, then they have a bunch of infinite solution. But let's look at this carefully. We'll start with the first equation. We'll try to, you know, put it in slope intercept form. Okay, so equation one is, you know what, let's split it into two lines. It's better to do that way, you can see it side by side. Let's split it like that. That way you can see it side by side. The first equation is 2x plus 5y is equals to 4, right? Is equals to 4. My 4 looks ugly there. Okay, so we want to put it in the slope intercept form, right? So what we do, we need to isolate y on the left. We say 5y is equals to minus 2x plus 4, right? And then we divide by 5, we get y is equals to minus 2 divided by 5x plus 4 divided by 5. You see that, right? Yeah, that's the first equation right there. So we see that the slope here, obviously we see that the slope, what the hell is wrong with this thing? The slope is m equals to minus 2 over 5, right? And this is the, and this right here, 4 over 5 is the y-intercept, okay? So let's solve the other equation. The second equation is 4x plus 10y is equals to 1, right? Again, we isolate y on the left. 10y is equals to minus 4x. Let me see, minus 4x plus 1, yeah? And then we say y is equals to minus 4 over 10x plus 1 over 10, okay? You know, so we divide things. I divide by 2, we get 2, and we get 5. So it would be minus 2 over 5x. So y is minus 2 over 5 plus 1 over 10. Notice something. Notice that the slope, their slope are the same. You see that, right? Here the slope is equals to minus 2 over 5. Remember, I told you the slope is the same and the y-intercept is different than the, is parallel. So those two lines are parallel because, you see, this is different and the slopes are the same, see? The slopes are the same. So, if you solve that equation, you won't have any solution because they are parallel. You know, we'll conclude that they are parallel. These are parallel. They are parallel lines, okay? Parallel lines. If you solve them, you won't get any solution. You know, but we keep going. Let's do another one. Let me see, where did I put it? Right here. This is the second example. Alright. So let's split it into two like we did before. That way we can see side by side. So we do 3x plus 2y is equals to 6. And on the other, well, let's do this first. We'll try to isolate y, right? We'll have to isolate y in one side on the left. That way we can see clearly what is going on, okay? It's basically a form of putting it in, yeah, we'll put it in slope intercept form. So we'll have 2y is equals to minus 3x plus 6, yeah? And then y divided by 2y is equals to minus 3 over 2x plus 6. You see that? So the slope is minus 3 over 2. And that is the y-intercept there. So we do the same thing on with the other equation. We have 9x plus 6y is equals to 11. And then we isolate y is equals to minus 9x, all right, plus 11. Okay, we divide both sides by 6. We have y is equals to minus 9 over 6, x plus 11 over 6. 3 divided this, you get 2. 3 divided this, you get 3. So the equation reduces to minus 3 over 2, x plus 11 over 6. See, so the slope here is m equals to minus 3 over 2. See, they're the same slope right there. The same slope, but they have different y-intercepts. So these are parallel lines, man. They are parallel lines, okay? Both of them, they are parallel. You know, so they are parallel to each other. So you see it clearly, right? You know, that's what we want to show, and we showed it. So let's go to the next one. This is the next one here. The next one, minus 4x plus 3y equals to 4. So we do the same thing. We divide it into 2. We do both sides. Minus 4x plus 3y equals to 4, right? We isolate y, 3y is equals to plus, where is equals to 4x. There's no need to write plus 4x, we just say 4x equals to 4x, because we moved 4x to the other side. It becomes positive minus plus 4y. I'm sorry, plus 4, sorry. Okay, so we divide by 3, we get y equals to 4 over 3x plus 4 over 3. You see that, right? So once you do that, you notice that the slope, then the slope is 4 over 3, and the y-intercept is 4 over 3. So we'll do the same thing with the other equation. It's minus 8x plus 6y is equals to 0. Okay, so we'll isolate y on the left. We'll have 6y is equals to 8x. We divide by 6, you have y. Okay, notice that we can leave the 0 here. That's fine. It doesn't change anything. It's 8 over 6x plus 0. If you divide anything, divide 0 with anything, it's still 0. Okay, so we get y. Yeah, we're done. Well, this simplify this. 3 divide that, 2 divide that, you get 3. 2 divide that, you get 4. So it's 4 over 3x plus 0. So the slope is equals to 4 over 3. So notice that they have the same slope. See that? But they have different y-intercepts, so they are parallel lines. They are parallel lines, okay? That's what that means. Alright? So basically, that's all that means, man. As long as you get that, you know that they are parallel. Let's go to example 4. We have 9x minus 2y equals to 0, 18. Okay, So let's do the same thing. We split the screen into two. Let's split it like that. And we say 9x minus 2y is equals to 0. 2y, let me see, we'll move 2y to the other side. It's okay. You know, we say 9x is equals to 2y. So we can rearrange 2y is equals to 9x. We didn't change nothing. We can even add 0. And we get rid of 3. Say y is equals to 9 over 2x plus 0. So slope is 9 over 2. You see it, right? Slope is 9 over 2 on the left side. Let's do the right side. The right side is minus 18x plus 4y is equals to 3. We isolate y. 4y is equals to 18x plus 3, okay? We divide by 4, you get y is equals to 18 over 4x plus 3 over 4. You see it there? So 4 can go, let me see, 2. 2 goes into 4, you get 2. 2 go in here, you get 9. So the what we got is 9 over 2x plus 3 over 4. Notice that, notice what is going on. Those two equations have the same slope, man. They have the same slope, but they have different y-intercepts. So they are parallel lines. So they are parallel lines, okay? You see that, right? You know, so I carefully chose this. That way they come out this way. That's the reason why I did that. You will see in a minute. So let's keep going. All right. Here is example 5. So we do the same thing we did before. We want to determine if those two equations, two equations, system of two linear equations, if they are parallel, perpendicular, or they are not, right? So we do it the way we did it before. 3x minus 5y is equals to minus 1, right? Okay. And then we do, we want to put it in a slope, in the form of slope y-intercept, okay? Alright, so we say 3x plus 1 is equals to 5y, okay? We want to isolate y. Let's move y to the left. 5y is equals to 3x plus 1. Notice we change nothing. We just shove things around. We just reshuffle things, that's all. I hope you see what happened in the first place. I moved the minus 1 to the left. Okay, and then it becomes a positive 1, right? And then I move minus 5y to the right, it becomes a positive, right? That's all I did, then I reshuffle it. So we want to get rid of 5. We say y is equals to 3 over 5x plus 1 over 5. You see that? You see it, right? You know, so then we see that the slope is equals to 3 over 5, right? And the y-intercept is that. We do the other side. We say 5x plus 3y is equals to 2. 3y is equals to minus 5x plus 2, okay? Y is equals to minus 5 over 2x plus 2 over 3. You see that, right? Now notice that the slopes are not, they're not equal, man. The slopes are not equal, right? They're not equal, so they're not perpendicular. I'm sorry, they're not equal, so they're not parallel, right? And the the Y intercept they're different, but that's not the issue. How do we determine if the product of the slopes will equal to minus one? Well, let's do it. I think they are, but let's do it. Then we'll say the slope, you know, the slope on the left. Well, let me see. The slope on the left is, suppose we do M times what? You see why I use different colors? M on the left side. M on the left side times M on the right side, okay? You get what? You get 3 over 5 times, what is that on the right? Minus 5 over 2, right? Did I do this right? Sorry. I see a mistake I made. Sorry about that. Let me correct. This is 3. That's 3, not 2. See? I made a mistake there because you divide them with 3. Sorry about that. Okay. So that would be... I make mistakes like that, but, you know, if you catch it, just know it's a mistake. Okay, so you multiply that. I knew it's a mistake because these have to cancel out. You cancel that. What do you get? You get minus 1. So basically, these two equations are perpendicular. Okay, that's one thing I want to show you. And then another thing I want to show you, they can be solved. They have a solution. I told you there are two methods. You can use method one is substitution, okay, to solve the system of linear equation, or you can use elimination. You know, so we want to try that. So if they can be solved, we'll solve them. So this is a linear, let me see. We'll have a system of linear equation. We'll have this. We'll have, let me use the red color. We'll have 3x. This is the original equation. Minus 1, okay? And then we'll have 5x plus 3y is equals to 2, okay? So this is a linear system. Let's solve it. We need to find the solution. You know, the first thing we did here to show you that they are perpendicular. If they are perpendicular, then they got a solution. They got at least one solution. I know they got exactly one solution, not at least. So how do we solve that? What do you want to use? We can do substitution. We can do elimination. The idea of substitution is you take one equation, you solve for one variable, then you take that variable, you put it into the second equation and solve. After you solve that, then when you solve that, you get the numerical value of one variable, and then you use that numerical variable and put it anywhere, and then get the numerical value of the other variable. That's all that is saying, man. You know, the elimination method is you try to make two of those. You target one variable, try to make it the same in both equations. You try to make the coefficient the same, and then you add the equation, and then you eliminate that variable. So let's try elimination, okay? We'll try elimination. So what we're gonna do, let's multiply the first equation with 3. So let's do this a little different here. I don't want to confuse you. So we'll multiply the first equation with 3. We'll multiply this equation by 3. We'll multiply the second equation. Let me see. We'll also multiply it by 3. That's fine. Because what happens if we do that, this will become 15. This will become 15. And they have opposite signs. So when we add it... No, I'm sorry, not 3. I'm glad I caught that. You multiply that one with 5. So when you add them together, you eliminate y. So let me show you. It's okay to multiply the equations, as long as you're doing the doing everything on both sides. So we do all that multiplication. What do we get? We get 9x minus 15y is equals to minus 3, okay? On the first equation. The second equation, we get 25x plus 15y is equals to 10. You see that? You see what we did? We didn't break any rule. We just multiply both sides, all the parts of the equation with the same variable. So you can do that. So after you do that, then you add. This, we actually using the process of elimination. We're using this one, sorry. The process of elimination. So we add, you add the, let me show you, you add this together, you add this together, you add this together. You know, that's how you do it. That's the process of elimination. So you add the, or start from the right hand side. We'll start wherever you want. Let's start from the left hand side. 9x plus 25x, what is that? That's 30. That's 34x, right? Yes, 34x. And then this one here, minus 15y plus 15y, you have 0. That's why, see, we eliminated y. That's why it's called the elimination method. So you add minus 3 plus 10, you get 7. You see that, right? So we have 34x equals to 7. We have x equals to what? 7 over 34, see? So we found one solution, okay? So once you get this solution, this value of y, you take that value, you put it in one of the original equation. Remember this, you can put it on this one or you can put it on that one. That's the original equation without multiplication. So let's put it on the first equation. So we said the first equation is 3x minus 5y is equals to minus 1. We put that value of x, we have 3 times 7 over 34, okay, minus 5y is equals to minus 1. So now we're going to solve for y. So if you multiply this out, what is 3 times 7 is 21, okay, 21 over 34 minus 5y is equals to minus 1. So you shuffle things and you want to isolate y. So you got 21 over 34 is equal, let's say plus 1 is equals to 5y, okay? You see what I'm doing? I moved minus negative 1 to the left, it becomes positive 1. I move negative 5y to the right, it becomes positive 5y. That's all I did, man. Now we'll solve for x, I mean for y. But first, you gotta simplify the left side. We can write this as 5y is equals to 21 over 34. And then we'll play that trick we'll play. Let's say 34 over 34. Notice that 34 over 34 is the same thing as 1. So we'll combine that. What do we get? We'll get 55, yeah? Over 34, okay? You see that, right? So basically we have 5y equals to 55 over 34. Okay, so we divide both sides by y, by 5, right? We divide by 5, we'll eliminate 5 on the left, and then we'll divide the other side, 55 over 34. We divide it by five. That's 1/5. You see, 5 can go here. What do you have? You have 11/34. So that's the value of y. Y is equals to 11/34. See? So we got value of x over there, and now we got value of y. See, right here and right here. So the equation is solved. You know, it's kind of a fraction, but you know, that's how you do, man. I don't know how you, the best way, well, it would be hard to test, but I think we are correct. We use the elimination method. We can also try the substitution method. Let me see. If you want, we can try this. I don't know, I don't have space, you know, but we can try the substitution method. Let me see. If you want to, we'll see if we get the same solution, right? Okay, let's try the substitution method. You know, so what I'm gonna do to have the space, right? Let's write the solution we find from elimination. We'll write it here. X equals to 7 over 34, okay? And then Y equals to what? Y equals to 11 over 34. 11 over 34. You see? I think we got the right solution. But let's try. We just did the elimination. Let's try substitution. See if we get the same thing. That's the way we can check it. Another way you can check it, you can draw the graph. You draw the each graph, they cross. Okay, once they cross, you see where they cross. That common point where they cross should be this. I'm sorry. Oh, what did I just do? Seven of. Yeah, that common point should be this point. It should give you x equals to 7 over 34, y equals to 11 over 34. You know, but let's do substitution method. Let's do it. Let me clean. I'll clean this. Okay, we'll go ahead and clear this up because we've done. I already wrote the other problem we're gonna solve, so we don't really have space. But the best thing is just clean it up quick. It goes out quick. This stuff cost me a lot of money, so it better work. You see. We clean that thing quick. So let's do substitution method. Don't forget we have two equations. Let me see. We have let's go back again. Just give me a minute. Let me get this. Let's use red. We have two equations, 3x minus 5y. These are the original equation minus 1. And what is the other one? The other one is 5x plus 3y is equals to 2. Okay, now this time, this solution gave us, elimination method gave us that. Let's use substitution method. The idea of substitution method is you isolate one variable and then you put it on the other equation. So let's call this equation 1, let's call this equation 2. It's easy to keep track of things if you do it this way. So we'll start with equation 1. Let's start with equation 1 and we'll solve for, let's see, what is easy? No, let's start with equation 2. You say from equation 2, from 2 above, right? You say 5x plus 3y is equals to 2. Let's solve for y. We say 3y is equals to 2 minus 5x. And we isolate y is equals to 2 over 3 minus 5 over 3x. Okay? So we take that value of y, we put it in the first equation. We put it in equation 1. And then we get, we put that value of y in equation 1, we get 3x. This is equation 1 now. Equation 1 is 3x, 5 minus 5y is equals to minus 1. We put that value of y in there, we get 3x minus 5. What is that value of, see right there? It's a 2 over 3 minus 5 over 3. X, right, equals to minus 1. You see what I did, right? So now you try to simplify things, and then well, after you simplify, you solve for x. So it becomes 3x minus, you multiply things out, you get 10 minus 10 over 3, it becomes 25 over 3x, okay? 25 over 3x, that's, let me put this on pause, I will come back in a minute. All right, let's continue. So, this is messy now, but we'll get it. And this is equals to minus 1, okay? So, let's simplify. So, we'll put the variables, you know, like we normally do. We'll combine the variables and we'll move the constant to the other side. So, we'll have 3x plus 25 over 3x is equals to 10 over 3 minus 1. You see that? So now this is where we use our trick, the trick that normally works for us. So let's combine this. How do you, the best way to do this is we'll write 9 over 3. To get the same denominator. If you divide 9 by 3, you get 3 plus 25x over 3 is equals to 10 over 3 minus, we'll write this as 3 over 3, we'll give you 1, okay? So we just playing tricks with the number. We didn't change it, understand? It changes nothing. What we just did changes nothing. Then we have 3 over here, you have 9x plus 25x, okay? And over here you have 10 minus 3 over 3, right there. Okay, so you keep simplifying. We'll just be patient. What is that then? 25x plus 9x, what is that? That's 34. That's 34x, right, over 3, is equals to, what is that? That's 7 over 3, okay? So you can cross multiply. It's okay to cross multiply now, because we're not going to break any rule. If you cross multiply, let me go like that, and that way we have enough space. If we cross multiply, what do you have? You have 34x times, actually, it's okay, 34x times 3, okay, is equals to 7 times 3, okay, so we didn't break any rule, but check this out though, we can divide again by 3. If we divide here by 3, divide here by 3, we get rid of 3. So we say 34x is equals to 7. X is equals to 7 over 34. You see that? We got one solution. Don't forget, man. X equals to what? 7? 7 over 34. See right here. So we know we're in the right track. We know we are in the right track. So we got one solution. So you take that variable, the value of that variable you just got. We use equation 2, right? And then, because I don't want redundancy. And then from there, we'll put that in equation. This is equation, okay. Yeah, you don't want redundancy. That's fine. So you can use any of these equations and put that value of x. So see, this is messy, man. So we take x equals to 7 over 34. We'll put it in any of those equations. Let's put it in x, 3x minus 5y equals to minus 1. We'll put it in there. So we'll have 3, 7 over 34. Minus 5y is equals to minus 1, right? Just follow. I know this is kind of messy, but there's nothing we can do. Sometimes elimination method is better because it eliminates stuff, you know. So, but we just want to make sure cross-check our work. That's why I wanted to do this substitution method. So we keep solving. What do we get there? 3 times 7 is 21. You get 21 over 34 minus 5y is equal to minus 1, okay? So 21 over 34 is, let me see, plus 1 is equal to 5y. And then you rearrange stuff, you know, well, if you want, you can leave 5y over there, the other side. You say 21 over 34 plus 34 over 34. It didn't, you know, we're just playing with the number. Because if you cross that out, you get 1. So you combine those two, you get 34. What are those two? Let me see, 55. Yeah, that's 55. 55 is equal to 5y. You divide both sides by 5. What do you get? You get 55 over 34 multiplied by, you divide them by 5. So you do it like that. It's equal to y, right? This cross this. You get 11 over 34. You see that we got the same thing. That's equal to y. You see that? You see that? We got the same thing. So we did it right. This is messy, but sorry, man. We you just keep on it, keep working on it, pay attention. You know you did it right. So we finished with that one. That was a lot of work, man. You know, but we did it. Everything checked out, so don't worry about it. Okay, here is example number 5 there. What I will do now, solve the a couple of system of equation. Just solve them with either elimination method or substitution method, whichever way I think is better. What you do, you look at it, see which method is less cumbersome, and then you apply that, okay? Now, this is x minus 1. One of the equation in the system is x minus 1 equals y equals to 7. X plus y is equals to 3. So I'm gonna eliminate, let's eliminate x. So the best way to do that is to multiply the first one by minus 1, right? Yeah, multiply that, let me see, multiply that by minus 1, okay? When after you do that, what do you get? You get minus x plus y is equal to minus 7, right? The second one, you just rewrite it the way it is, plus y is equal to 3. So you add that together to eliminate x. See, x will cancel, you get 2y is equal to, what is that, minus 4. You see that, right? Because you add these two together. Then it becomes y equals to minus 4 over 2. It's equals to minus 2. See? That's what you get. So once you get that value of y, once you get y, it's equals to minus 2. So you try to put that in. You choose any of those equations, put it in there. It doesn't matter which one. Let's put it in the second equation. We'll put it on this one. So you put y equals to minus 2 there. You have x minus, let's see, minus 2y, right? No, I'm sorry. I'm doing it backward. Because that's y equals to minus 2. So you say x plus minus 2. Yeah, minus 2, right? Because y is equal to minus 2. You replace y with minus 2. It's equal to 3, right? And then that would be x minus 2 is equal to 3. That would be x equals to 3 plus 2. That would give you 5. So x is equal to 5. So the solution for the equation, for the system, is 5 and minus 2. Okay, you can check that. We can go ahead and check that by putting it, see if if it, check it in one of them, or you can check it in both of them, it doesn't matter. See if it evaluates. So let's check it in the first equation. We'll say, hang on a minute, we'll check it, we've got plenty of space. We'll check it on this one, x minus y is equals to 7, okay? So we'll put y, x equals to 5, y equals to minus 2, okay? And then we'll ask ourselves, we evaluate to 7. And then we'll say 5. Remember, this is like minus 1 times minus 2, so it becomes plus 2. Is that equals to 7? That's what we're trying to figure out. Yes, 7 is equals to 7. So that is true. So you see, the equation evaluates. If you want, we can also put it in the second equation. The second equation is x plus y equals to 3. X plus y is equals to 3. That's the second equation, this one here. Okay, we'll put that this value into that equation. We'll have 5 minus 2, is it equals to 3? That's what we're trying to evaluate. We simplify, the left side is 3. It's equals to 3. So it's true. So we know we got the right solution. We know that this other pair is the solution of that system. So we're done. You see that? So this system of equation with two linear equations in two variables, we solved it. And we got that as the solution of the system. It's an equation that solves to one solution, not several, okay? Okay, so we'll move on to example number 6. Look at that one there. You know, so this one is x minus y equals to minus 1. X plus y equals to 7. So we'll see. If you eyeball it, see what you can eliminate. Suppose you add those two equations together, you eliminate y. So let's add them together, we'll get 2x, y is gone. It's equals to, we're adding them, so it's equals to 6. X equals to 6 over 2, which is 3. You see that, right? So you take that value of x, and you put it in any of the equations. So let's put x equals to 3 in any of those equations. We'll choose the first equation, x minus y equals to minus 1. We'll put that value there. We'll get 3 minus y is equals to minus 1. And then we'll have 3 plus 1 is equals to y, right? And then it's 4 is equals to y. So we'll get value of y and we'll get value of x here. Okay, so the question is this or that pair, 3 and 4. If see, that's the solution we'll find right here. That's the solution of the equation. One solution we'll find for the equation. If we put it in those two equations, we'll evaluate the true. Well, let's see that. Let's see that the first equation, let me see. Let's change the ink. The first equation is x minus y equals to minus 1. So we'll put this in there. We have 3 minus 4 is equals to minus 1. We'll simplify the left side. We get minus 1 is equals to minus 1. And this is true. So we do that with the other equation, which is x plus y equals to 7. X plus y is equals to 7. We'll say with this, make it evaluate to true. We'll put that in there. We'll say it's 3 plus 4, is that equals to 7? We'll say yes, 7 is equals to 7, and this is true. So we say we did solve it. This is the solution of the system. So we got it right. You know, so let's move on to the next one. We'll move on to the next one. This is the next one right here. Okay. The next one is x minus y equals to minus 5, x plus y equals to 1. So we'll solve that system of linear equation, right? Each of them in two variables, there are two equations in the system. So we can also do the process of elimination. See, when you see the equation, you eyeball it. See what is best. So we'll add those two equations together to eliminate y. We get 2x. 2x is equals to, if you add those two, minus 4, see? X is equals to minus 4 over 2, which is minus 2. So x is equals to minus 2 is one solution. You take that, you put it in any of the equation, right? Let's put it in number 2, this one here. We'll put it on this one. So then we get minus 2 plus y is equals to 1. Alright, so we say y is equals to 1 plus 2, right? That is 3. Okay, so it's y is equals to 3. That's what we got. So those two things are the ordered pair we got, minus 2 and 3. Okay, so we'll evaluate the truth if we put it in those two equations. I think so. Let's check that. Suppose I put it in, I put this into the first one, x minus y is equals to minus 5, right? You put that in there, what do you get? Minus 2 plus, minus 3, is that equals to minus 5? I think so, see? It's minus 5 here, it's equals to minus 5. So this is true. So that evaluates. Let's do the same thing on the other equation. We'll have that. We'll put it in x plus y equals to 1, right? And we'll say minus 2 plus 3 is that equals to 1. Is that equals to 1? That's the question. Is that equals to 1? I think so. Because if we simplify the left, you get 1 is equals to 1. So this is true. So we know we got the right solution, okay? Alright. So we'll move on to the next one. Number 8. X minus Y equals to minus... X minus Y equals to minus 5. X plus y equals to minus 1. Yeah, that's different from, it looks like the same we did it before, but no, it's different. Okay, so you have two systems. It's similar to what we did before. You just add them together to eliminate y. If you add those two together to eliminate y, you get 2x is equals to minus 6. You get x equals to minus 3, okay? That's one solution there. So you take that solution, you put it in one of the equations. You put it in the first one, you have, minus 3. Minus 5. We'll put it on this one. So it becomes minus 3 minus y equals to minus 5, right? Okay, and then you move things around, you get minus 3 plus 5 is equals to y, right? And then you get y is equals to 2. So this is y and that's x. So the ordered pair is minus 3 and 2. Okay, so we test, see if the would that evaluate true in both equations. It's a form of check. You don't have to check, but if you check, then you can catch, see if you made a mistake. So it's better to check. So let's take this other pair. We use the first equation, x minus y is equal to minus 5. We'll put it in there. We'll have minus 3, minus, let me see, minus 2. Is that equal to minus 5? I think so, because if you simplify the left hand, you have negative 5 is equal to negative 5, which is true. This is true, man. Okay. So we'll try that in the second equation. We just did it in the first. We'll try it in the second. The second is x plus y is equal to what? Let me see. Equals to minus 1. So we'll put that value in there. Minus 3 plus 2 is equal to minus 1. Okay, no, well, is it equal to minus 1? That's the question we're trying to prove. We're trying to answer. Then it says, yes, if you simplify the left, you have minus 1 is equal to minus 1. This is true. So we know we did a good job. So we know that this other pair is the solution of the equation because it checked out. Okay? So we did well right there. But I'm going to leave it there because I think I'm very tired now. Hey, listen. Subscribe to my channel, share and like this video. If you have any question or comment, leave it under the video and I will get to it as soon as I can. Okay, so we'll leave it there. Thanks for coming. I'll see you in the next video. Okay, thanks. Bye.